Webb telescope just captured this image of a star shooting jets at thousands of kilometers per second. What you're looking at is HH30, a baby star in the process of being born, seen nearly edge-on. See that bright streak shooting up and down? That's a massive jet of gas blasting into space at speeds that would get you from Earth to the Moon in under an hour. And that dark band across the middle, that's where all the action is happening. A disk of dust and gas that's slowly but surely building planets as we watch. This cosmic nursery sits in the constellation Taurus, about 450 light-years from Earth. That means when this light began its journey toward Webb's mirrors, the Netherlands was fighting for independence from the Spanish Habsburg Empire. But thanks to Webb's incredible infrared eyes, we're seeing details that no human has ever seen before. The James Webb Space Telescope is basically a time machine made of gold. Well, sort of. Its massive 6.5-meter mirror is coated in gold for a very specific reason: to capture light that our human eyes can't even see, and that's exactly what makes it perfect for spying on baby stars. Now, we've actually been watching this star for a while with Hubble, but look at the difference. It's like going from watching a football game from the nosebleed seats to suddenly having front row access. But Webb isn't working alone. We've got Webb looking at the infrared light, Hubble capturing the visible light, and another telescope called ALMA looking at even longer wavelengths. Together, they're giving us the most complete picture of a baby star we've ever had. And this matters because different types of light tell us different parts of the story. The infrared light that Webb sees can pierce through the dust clouds that normally block our view. And what we're seeing there is absolutely mind-blowing. HH30 isn't just any baby star. It's putting on a light show that's helping us understand how every star, including our sun, might have been born. What we're looking at is called a protostar, basically a star in its infancy. And just like human babies, stellar babies can be pretty messy eaters. As gravity pulls material toward the growing star, not all of it makes it to the surface. Instead, some of it gets shot out in those spectacular jets we can see. These jets are moving at mind-bending speeds. We're talking about 700,000 kilometers per hour. That's like circling Earth 17 times in just 1 hour. And as these super-fast jets slam into the surrounding gas and dust, they create shockwaves that make the whole region glow, giving us this incredible view. About 4.6 billion years ago, our sun was probably putting on a similar show. So in essence, this observation is kind of like looking at our own family album, but from before we were born. And speaking of birth stories, there's something else hidden in this image that's absolutely crucial to understanding how planets like Earth form. This dark band in the middle is a massive disk of dust and gas. And inside that disk, something incredible is happening. We're watching the very first steps of planet formation, and it starts smaller than you might imagine. We're talking about dust grains so tiny that a million of them could fit across a single millimeter. That's about the size of a single bacterium. These microscopic particles are the building blocks of entire worlds. Every rocky planet, including Earth, started out as nothing more than cosmic dust. Webb and ALMA have shown us something fascinating. The larger dust grains, still smaller than a grain of sand, are gathering in a thin layer at the center of the disk. Meanwhile, the smaller particles are spread out more widely. This sorting of dust grains is crucial. When the larger particles gather together like this, they start to clump. These clumps grow into pebbles, pebbles into boulders, boulders into planetesimals, and eventually into full-sized planets. We're literally watching the recipe for planet formation being followed in real time. But such events are happening right now across our entire galaxy. Every time you look up at the night sky, you're seeing thousands of stars, and many of them likely formed just like this. We've already discovered over 5,000 planets around other stars, and each one of those planets probably started out just like what we're seeing in HH30, tiny specks of dust slowly coming together in a cosmic dance. And this is where the story gets even more interesting. Dr. Ryo Tazaki and his team at the University of Tokyo have just made an incredible discovery. They found something unexpected, a mysterious spiral pattern in the disk, similar to what we've seen around other young stars. But what's causing these spirals? The team has three fascinating possibilities. First, that powerful jet we saw might be wiggling, creating these spiral patterns. Or there could be a hidden companion star lurking within the disk itself. But here's the most intriguing possibility. About 1,000 years ago, another star might have flown past HH30, close enough to leave its gravitational fingerprint in the form of these spiral patterns. These findings aren't just fascinating, they're shaping our understanding of how the cosmos works. And Webb isn't done yet. As we speak, it's turning its golden eye toward other star-forming regions, looking for more systems like HH30.
Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.